looking at the radicals unit here, and what I want to do is I want to really introduce you to radicals and make sure you understand all the little nitty-gritty stuff that goes with it. Here's a typical radical. So we'll call this entire thing a radical. That's why we got it over here. And if you read this definition of what a radical is all about, it says it consists of a root symbol, an index, and something called the radicand. So here's the entire radical. That is it. This number here, this 3, right, that you got there, that means you're taking the cube root of something. That is actually called the index, all right? And then, of course, here's your radical sign. So this is what tells you it's a radical. You may notice a cube root or a square root or whatever you want to do, but that's actually called a radical sign. And this inside here is actually called the radicand. Okay, so that's what you're taking either the square root or the cube root of. So I've got it written down here so you can, if you got a problem with reading my writing, there it is here. So here's the index. That's this guy. Most of the time you're going to be dealing with square roots and cube roots. Here's the radical sign. There it is right here. Here's the radicand. In this case, it's 29. Okay, this whole thing together, and you can see my kind of fuzzy little diagram here, that whole thing is called a radical. And you're going to find that we have actually two types of radicals. One is what we call an entire radical. And what an entire radical means is if you're going to square root something or you're going to cube root something, let's say the square root of 17, the cube root of 25, this whole thing is considered to be an entire radical. What is a mixed radical? A mixed radical is your second type. Oh, mixed. Now, a mixed radical looks like this. You have a number up front, but that is a whole number or some kind of rational number up front, and you've got a cube root, something like, I don't know, 4 after that. So you have a number up front and the radical. That's why it's called a mixed radical. So you have both. Here, an entire radical, there is no number up front. It's just the radical by itself. For this one, look for things like the 4 in front. So if you look at all the definitions that I have down here, look what it says. The definition of a mixed radical is a product of a rational number and a radical. For example, 1/2 cubed root of 6. There's that number up front I was telling you about. An entire radical is just the radical. Look, square root of 32, cube root of 2 root 2 to the power of 5. Whatever it is, the two important things to note here is that you have an entire radical with no number up front and a mixed radical that has some sort of number up front. You now know what an index is. You now know what a radicand is. Here's the start to a great, great unit.